Greetings, this is Vlodril and welcome to the review for Inmates. Inmates is a psychological horror game made by David Andresian, a sole developer, and published by Iceberg Interactive, which provided me with a key for this review. You play as Jonathan Bradley, who wakes up in a nightmarish environment, trapped in a semi-familiar prison and with a splitting headache. Your goal? Find out where you are and what is going on. But first things first. The game offers a pretty poor option screen. The only graphic options you have is low, mid and high. You can also enable or disable motion blur and vSync. That's all. You can pick up your mic sensitivity, brightness and language, and that's the whole option menu. Worse, there are no actual sound levels for you to pick, so if you want to modulate the sound at all, you must do it out of game, which frankly is ridiculous. Another bad thing about the option screen, you can't actually get to it once you get into the game, only from the main menu. I guess since there aren't any settings to pick, the developer didn't feel the need to provide players with such an option. Gameplay wise, the controls are very simple. You can play with a mouse and keyboard or a controller, and there are basically only three buttons to use apart from movement. Left click is interact with an object, right click is move out of puzzles, and F is light a match. Matches are the main form of lighting dark areas, but the game has plenty of light, so they are seldom used. Thankfully for you, when you do need to use them, the game provides you with an abundance of them, so you don't need to fear that you will run out of them. Inmates offers no manual saving system, but the checkpoint system is not bad, and the linearity of the game makes it so it's not really an issue. Walking around is slow, and the game disables the sprint option after the very first area, so you will walk everywhere, slowly. The path is mostly linear as you explore this prison environment, and the game relies on puzzles to impede your progress instead of the normal monster such games usually employ. Another thing to note here is that the game will often lock you in place while the character is having a monologue, or even prevent you from leaving an open area unless you solve a specific puzzle. The game actually turns you around in one instance instead of letting you backtrack out of an open door. Moving around, as I said, is done at a slow walking pace, and the game slows down even further at some sections to try to amplify the horror effect and to artificially pad the length of the game, I guess. The puzzles themselves I did not mind. They start fairly simple and remain simplistic as the game progresses, so there is nothing egregious about them. Lacking a master is not a bad thing in and of itself, but that means that Inmates leans heavily to jump scares for the horror factor, both audio and visual ones, and without any audio options they become annoying since they are frequently used. Moving through the prison, you will find various notes to examine, with often cryptic quotes, and you will go through a journal the character obtains. But only when he feels like it's time for you to read a new page, you have no control over it. That is your main way to understand what is happening to you, apart from some discussions through a radio with a stranger and the endgame exposition. There is no great mystery though, since it becomes apparent from early on what the storyline of the game is about. The game lacks a sense of suspense and urgency too, which is a must-have for games of this genre. Inmates was made by a sole developer and it shows. The game is as indie as it comes. Apart from the lack of options, graphics-wise the game has some pretty poor textures everywhere also. The voice acting is actually one of the better made parts of the game. I found the performances convincing and of a higher quality than the rest of the game. The time it took to complete was also very short, 3 hours, but I can excuse that on the price it is offered, which is 10 euros or dollars. In conclusion, the game offers a short, unpredictable horror story, with limited gameplay and basic puzzles. It does offer that for cheap, so it's up to you to decide if it's worth the price of admission and your time.